Now, Force of Rage. I've heard some people say this is a really good card. I think it's just okay. I would not be super disappointed to first pick it, but I'm more inclined towards something like Ingenious Infiltrator. Best common in the pack is probably the Irregular Cohort. Nothing really exciting outside of those three cards and maybe the Dregscape Sliver. I think I'm going to start with Ingenious Infiltrator. I like to get more reps drafting ninjas, as it is a tricky archetype to master. Sling Gang Lieutenant. I think this is one of the best non-rare cards in the set. Of course, it's better in red-black than blue-black, but you're playing this in any black deck, and, you know, I'm not locked into being ninjas so far yet. So I'll take this Sling Gang and then just see where things go from here. If this wasn't in the pack, I wouldn't really have any great options. Be looking at something like maybe Ransack the Lab or just changing colors for a Rocks Veteran or something like that. Okay, so, I mean, it's hard to argue with pick 2 Sling Gang, pick 3 Munitions Expert. There's also Undead Augur, which is pretty strong, and Gluttonous Slug. I think I'm going to go with the Munitions Expert, even though it's a little awkward having both Expert and Infiltrator. I think I'm just not going to... I mean, like I said, pick 2 Sling Gang, pick 3 Munitions Expert. Just how can you argue with that, no matter what your first pick was? Okay, Defile. Black is the one color that I'm certain to be. If I was sure that I was going to be like blue-black with more islands than swamps, then I would take Manowar. But since Defile is such a good mono-black card and I could easily be red-black from this position, I think I will take that. This is a pretty close pick, though, between Defile and Manowar. Well, Ethel, I appreciate your sub. I appreciate you gifting the sub, and Simply Cool, welcome to the team. Okay, so this is getting interesting. Carrion Feeder is passable in ninjas just because it's a one drop, though, you know, you prefer Changeling Outcast to have evasion. But this is pretty good in red black because of the sacrifice thing. A lot of times you have tokens, and you might even wind up with Goat Nap. It's kind of similar role to the Bogardin Dragonheart, but it is a mono black card, which black is the color I'm sure I'm going to be. Could also look at Goblin War Party. I think with all these factors combined, I'm going to take the Carrion Feeder, though I think it would be fine to take the Dragonheart or the War Party as well. Here we have things drying up a little bit. I could take an Igneous Elemental, which is not great in red-black, but if I end up with a couple of Ransack the Labs, it's okay. If I shift gears looking back towards blue, the Windcaller Aven is fine because it can give a ninja flying on a key turn. Birthing Boughs, sideboard card, snow-covered swamp, whatever. I guess the Windcaller Aven is probably the best of the cards that has a chance of making my deck from this position. And now I'll shift back towards red and take the Goblin War Party. Now we're looking at the Gargantua or the Lava Dart. Lava Dart is like, you can play it as your 23rd card or it's a great sideboard card. The Gargantua, on the other hand, is going to be a good main deck card, like if you're just looking for a top end creature or if you have a couple of Ransack the Labs. Though the Dart, I mean, is good with Ransack the Lab also. I think I'm going to pick my first Gargantua over my first Dart, but that's a pretty close pick as well. Probably take Return from Extinction based on the strength of these two creatures. And Ransack, perfect. Yeah, so at this point, I would say I'm choosing between either red black goblins or blue black ninjas. I'm not going to try to build a Grixis deck, but I'm liking my position from either of these two forks in the road, so to speak. Yeah, Scout's probably better actually than the Knight. Oh dear. Best card in the format, potentially. Winds of Abandon. This is a nice pack for if you're a white drafter, and not so great if you're a Grixis drafter. I mean, Unearth is the only card that I would consider here, but it's pretty hard to twist my arm into taking Unearth over Winds of Abandon. I'm just going to take this, and I don't know where the draft's going to go from here. I mean, I could be white-black if I wanted to. Or I don't know. Maybe I'll get a Smiting Helix and play Mardu or something like that, but this card is just too strong to pass at this point in the draft. Hard to turn down a Matron when I already have Munitions Expert and Sling Gang Commander. Nothing great in blue or black or white, so... Alright. Alright, so I guess I can, for now I'll move all the non-red black cards to the sideboard and we'll just see where the draft takes us, but looking like I'll go with a more normal red black goblins. Ooh, another card that it's really, really painful for me to pass. I love Reap the Past, and you know, as a potential splash, I'm intrigued by this card. I think it would be foolish for me to take it over just a great, clean-cut, premium card in my colors. So I'm going to make the disciplined pick here, but it's pretty hard for me to pass Reap the Past. I do love that card. Sure, so Blade Back Sliver, just totally fine. 2-drop creature. Scavengers, fine too. I wouldn't mind picking up a Silumgar Scavenger in this deck. Yeah, Goblin War Party is just really good in this type of deck, I think. I'm happy to have several of those. Ooh, I would love both the Dragonheart and the Sinkhole, but I don't think I can pass the removal spell at this point. Sinkhole is even really good if I'm going to play Ransack the Lab. I don't have a ton of removal yet, and then I also don't have like the Goat Naps that would make the Dragonheart a really, really important card. It's more of just a value card at this point in the draft, so Sinkhole it is. Then Unearth coming around, so I got to pick up the Winds of Abandon and still wield the card that I wanted from this pack. Not bad. Vengeful Devil's fine. I'm not interested in Goblin Champion. I've tried that card a bit and I think it's pretty bad. I don't know. I have been drafting black-red a lot lately. Maybe it's because I value the Sling Gang Commander and the Munitions Expert so high. But I do like this this archetype a lot. Basically, my draft strategy for Modern Horizons is I really like any combination of the Sultai colors, and I really like red-black. I don't really do, like, you know, the white-red beatdown decks too often, but I do, for whatever reason, just really like this color combination. I tend to like red-black in basically any draft format. It's kind of my colors. Okay, so here we have a Vengeful Devil. A Wart-Eye Witch. No reason to want the Snow-Covered Swamp. Not enough payoff to go for the Igneous Elemental. I already have two Return from Extinctions. I mean, I guess Vengeful Devil's kind of good in multiples, right? Like, if I assemble double Vengeful Devil Sling Gang Lieutenant or something like that. Good with Unearth as well. Ooh. In a different world, that could be a huge payoff card for me. But at this point, I'm thinking I'll just take the Dragonheart. Yes. Pyrophobia. Man, I always see this card. I never have enough Planeswalkers to make it good. Smoke Shaper's decent, or a third Gargantua. I mean, yeah, I don't think I'll use three Gargantuas, like, if unless I somehow got multiple additional Ransack the Labs. But I should probably just take Smoke Shaper here. I guess let's take a look at what my deck is going to look like. I don't really have that many cuts. I don't know. It's pretty thin whether or not the Smoke Shaper even makes my deck, but I guess it's better than the... But, yeah, I mean, I don't know. Am I going to board this in a grindy matchup or something? The Gargantua? Smoke Shaper's kind of just not great for me. I'll take it anyway. Feaster of Fools. I wanted to get a little more experience with this card. Seems good in this kind of token deck. So I'll take the Settle Beyond Reality, and then I could see, like, if I play against a deck with multiple 8-8 Murasa Behemoths that I can't answer with my red removal, maybe I board in the White Splash or something like that. Sure. Ooh, another War Party. That's nice. Creature type Devil. Third Return from Extinction is, again, pretty thin. But I could see boarding it in a grindy matchup. I ended up with no ways to use Snowland, so who cares about that? Okay. So I guess this will be the maybe pile up here. Pretty happy with one return from extinction. Maybe the carrion feeder is not great. I didn't end up with Goat Nap or anything. It's pretty good with Vengeful Devil, I guess. I have three disposable bodies plus the war parties. Oh, put it in the maybe pile. Looks like a. I could play 18 lands. I guess with the double Matriot and the three war parties, I'm not that likely to flood with this deck. Warrior. Any warriors for the Return to Extinction thing? No. Well, I'm thinking Ninja of the New Moon looks good, right? So I could do this with 18 lands. Probably don't need 18. I guess I would love to have like 18 lands, including a cycling land, but didn't get one of those. Deciding between the 18th land or the 6th drop and 17 lands, kind of awkward, but. This, I think, is about where I want to be. This again, the Smoke Shaper and the Carrion Feeder, totally fine considerations. Even the Sand Sprinter is fine. Well, I could slant black because I have Defile. Or I could slant red because it's slightly better to keep all Mountain Hand than all Swamp Hand. Though I do have Ransack the Lab as well. I think I'm going to slant red. I think the Ninja of the New Moon is going to prove to be a nice late draft pickup. Oh, I like this hand. Oh, I should play the snow-covered swamp. You're right. There's no reason not to do that. Just gonna block. I think in white red against black red, I'm happy to just trade off at any point that I can. Get my two for ones here and there. Speaking of two for ones, that looks like a good target for my munitions expert. I'm just gonna go ahead and do that on my main phase. Sure. This could be a good matchup for Vengeful Devil for reasons like this one. Pow. Well, I could make another attack with the three goblins. Opponent blocks, then I pyrophobia the veteran, I ping for one, so effectively I trade a goblin and a pyrophobia for a veteran and three damage. I guess it's fine. I'm gonna have to draw something if I'm going to keep the pressure on. And now we pump the brakes. Well, I guess I'm going to make it a 7-7 and make my opponent have white removal. It's tricky because, like, I want it to be a 5-5 to be out of pyrophobia range. I want it to be a 7-7 to be out of magmatic sinkhole range. But then the more I sacrifice, the more I get blown out by Settle Beyond Reality, which seems like it's more likely for my opponent to have Settle Beyond Reality than to have pyrophobia at this point. Magmatic sinkhole is very possible as well. So I'm gonna go for 7-7. Hey Luis, welcome man, how are you? Well, I will confess that my teammates and I were having a debate about Feaster of Fools, and I was like, I don't like it that much. You know, six mana, you invest a lot, then it just gets killed. The whole discussion, I did not know it had Convoke. So yeah, this card is better than I was giving it credit for. Okay, well, I can now unearth my munitions expert after having sacrificed all my goblins. Unearth really not seeming to do much on this board. Don't think I have to worry about dying next turn. Famous last words. I could just cycle. If I get back the blade back sliver, and I put my opponent to four, and then they find an answer to the Feaster of Fools. Tricky. Normally, I don't like to make a play like that. You know, like add randomness to the game when I feel like I'm ahead. I usually don't like a play like that. But I do have some draws that really put the game far in my grasp, and Sling Gang Lieutenant is one of them. Removal spell would be another. I like the result as well. Luis tends to have the opposite approach to the game as me, where he likes to introduce random elements at any and all points just to make the game more exciting. But I'm glad we came to the same conclusion there, cycling the Unearth. It did work out well. So red-white slivers. Well, make the groundbreaking change of basic swamp for snow-covered swamp. Otherwise, I'm not seeing much to change here. Maybe return from extinction if I think I'm going to be trading off a lot. Ninja of the New Moon, probably a tiny bit weaker in this matchup. I guess either of these expensive cards. Okay. going to swap my new moon for a smoke shaper. Townsend asking a good question about Carrion Feeder. I think Carrion Feeder is a pretty good card in red-black. It was basically the last card I ended up cutting from my deck, but sometimes your deck has more of a sacrifice theme. Sometimes you're playing Goat Nap to like steal the opponent's creature and sacrifice it. So in general, I think Carrion Feeder is a pretty high-value card, but I did make the judgment call to cut it from this deck. I think I'll just do nothing this turn. And if my opponent attacks, I can block and then unearth. And if my opponent doesn't attack, like they might just play a fourth land Rocks Veteran or something like that, then I can just cycle the unearth end of turn. Okay, so now we've come to a situation where the Bladeback Sliver doesn't really do much on this board. So I'm going to just cycle. I'm going to grab the Sling Gang, and then as a long-term plan, I can either block or use the Sling Gang ability to get Matron and Sling Gang into the graveyard, and then I can return from Extinction, pick them both up, eventually search for Munitions Expert. So that's many turns down the road, but at least gives me something to work towards, spend my mana on. My opponent stuck with no red mana. All right, so I can go Sack, Matron, Vengeful Devil, Ping, Pyrophobia. Alternatively, I could just attack with everything and then play Pyrophobia. Roughly same either way, because I can't really attack with the Sling Gang Commander. Unless I kill the veteran first. So I guess I'll try to kill the veteran before anything else. Good. Good discipline for my opponent to not just cash in the shelter, try to hit lands. Quite the draw. Kid Confidant, thank you for the sub. I don't even know if my plan makes sense here. I guess it does. Hey, Mr. John, thank you for the kind words and for the cheer. You didn't have to do that, but it's very much appreciated. And I'll see you whenever you have a chance to stop by and join us for a stream, but thanks again. So I drew the Munitions Expert, that's very good. I can pick that up with Return from Extinction. don't think that's going to be good enough. Okay, so far so good. I've had a handful of articles come out on CFB the last couple of weeks. My stuff covered, I analyzed the Red Bull Untapped Modern Qualifier Tournaments and then wrote a little bit about Standard. So if you want to check those out, you can go to the Channel Fireball website. But in general, there's pretty much content on any format you could be interested in from a wide variety of great players on Channel Fireball. I found Mike Sigrist's old article about Modern Horizons draft to be pretty helpful. Informed some of the strategies you're seeing on stream today. For anybody wondering about my stream schedule, I'm going to be traveling. I'm leaving for Europe for the Mythic Championship on Thursday. So no stream on Thursday. But today and tomorrow will be slightly extended streams. I'm probably going to stick to Modern Horizons draft today. And then tomorrow I'll be playing Arena, either M20 Limited or Standard or something like that. Perfect timing on the Blade back sliver. And I'd also like to say thanks to Ultimate Guard for supporting me and supporting the stream. You can get information about Ultimate Guard products as well as a link to their website in the panels below my stream. Trumpeting Herd is one of the more annoying cards for red-black removal-based deck. Alright. I feel like I pretty much have to just play Sling Gang Commander and pass. The alternative is Pyrophobia, attack for 4, and then do nothing, and then be faced with kind of same situation next turn. But if I play the Sling Gang, that unlocks Munitions Expert as a removal spell, and can allow me to just double spell next turn, so nice setup card. Triple spell even. With the Feaster of Fools that I recently learned has Convoke. Ben, welcome to the stream, man. I was just giving a shout-out to Siggy for writing good articles on Modern Horizons Limited, but Ben Weitz has also written some good stuff in addition to just watching him crush those Limited Grand Prix. I've learned a lot. So welcome to the stream, Ben. Happy to have you here. So, if I believed my opponent was going to pump the Frostwalla, I could get effectively a 6-point life swing by blocking with a Goblin. Goblins are somewhat precious with the Munitions Expert coming next turn. So maybe I'm supposed to just take this one more time before I turn the race around. Alright, so looks appealing to just go Munitions Expert, Pyrophobia. Then I'll have six creatures out, and I could play Feaster of Fools with Convoke, or I could just get in a big attack. Probably best to get in a big attack. Maybe not, though. My opponent's red-green, so short of Thornado, it's pretty hard to imagine them killing the Feaster of Fools. This is kind of the ideal matchup for it. So I could just try to play it as like 7-7 or even a 9-9 killing two hits. 7-7's likely to kill in two hits anyway with the Sling Gang Commander. So if I make it a 9-9, then I can actually put it into combat, which is pretty good. Yeah, that looks good. Great card, not likely to be enough here. So at the end of my opponent's turn, I can just defile, whatever creature is appropriate, and then turn on the blade back slivers. Opponent found Igneous Elemental and Frostwalla. Not good enough. So, against red-green, we have Gargantua, Return from Extinction. So basically, I don't want cards that are going to trade unfavorably against Elephants from Thundering Herd or Mother Bear or whatever it might be. So, these bigger, grindier cards are the ones that I'm a little bit more interested in. Might actually cut Ninja of the New Moon, though I do think it's in general better in my deck than a Gargantua. The Devils, I think, are not great in this matchup, but they are just pretty good in my deck in general. No, sadly, Modern Horizons is not on Arena. This hand's a bit awkward. Like I said, I don't think the Vengeful Devils really excel in this particular matchup, though. I guess having two could be nice. Take down two creatures. Is this a card that people generally like, the Vengeful Devil? Ben, if you're still in the chat, I know you like drafting red-black. Do you like Vengeful Devil as a card? Not really, it's okay. Yeah, I guess that's generally how I feel about it. Luis says it's okay in red black and pretty bad in most other color combinations. That makes sense. Alright, Frostwalla. Chooses land for Winding Way and hits three. So my opponent should be all set with their mana. Seems worthwhile to just unearth the Death Touch Changeling against like red-green monsters deck. That card's gonna have a full card worth of value. Ben agrees that Vengeful Devil is pretty good in black-red, but pretty unplayable in the other red color combinations, and don't even get me started on the non-red color combinations. Yeah, they're good in multiples, so you can imagine a couple turns down the road if I Magmatic Sinkhole a big creature and then just start taking out the two toughness creatures, you know, at no cost. That's pretty good. Throes of Chaos. Whoa! Yeah, definitely lots of monsters in this deck. The Throes of Chaos eventually hits Frostwalla. Can't exactly kill the Frostwalla yet, so I'm just gonna pass. And I do have Magmatic Sinkhole available. Oh, I was fooled by the purple verified check mark, but I see that LSV doesn't have any special status in my chat. I'm going to knight the Sir LSV. And Andrea. Andrea as well. I knight the Sir Andrea Mengucci. You guys have swords now. Use them well. Yeah, the most recent Jund deck that I streamed with is under the Stream Decker tool. Oh, that's actually that's a I copied that list from the Red Bull Untapped qualifier. But yeah, basically if you copy the one under the Stream Decker tool and then just swap the Dreadhorde Arcanist for something like a Plague Engineer, that would probably be a good starting point. Okay, so we have Igneous Elemental probably coming down to take out one of my Vengeful Devils. Or finish off the Changeling. I am okay with that, and then I can untap and go Pyrophobia Ping Ping. Except that my opponent's going to ruin that plan by playing a snow land. Now that's scary, the conifer worm. I'm gonna have to kill that with Magmatic Sinkhole. So actually, I could try to quadruple shoot the Frostwalla. like shoot it twice in a turn, make my opponent pump, and then kill this and kill this. I don't think I need to do that though. A lot of great options here. I guess the expert is kind of just perfect to kill off Conifer Worm. And just going to try to get my opponent with the slow bleed here. Wow, that was a good draw. All right, so we're going to start with Pyrophobia. And the reason I do this pre-combat is if my opponent discards to make a bear mid-combat, I can now just shoot it down with the double Vengeful Devil. Then we come in with these four. So I'm at 8 life. Let's say worst case scenario, my opponent end of turn makes a bear, then untaps and draws the dragon or something like that. Still not really at risk of dying, especially with the matron as a blocker. So I'll just play this, search up Sling Gang Commander, and then I should be able to find lethal next turn. My opponent is flooded with ways to use land in hand, but doesn't have enough lands in hand to make it really good. I feel like I can't really mess this one up. So let's say they make a bear, they take three, I sack a bunch of goblins, two more from the devils. Okay, 2-0. Yeah, I've been liking black-red goblins a lot lately. I mean, so a couple times in a row, I've just had the premium uncommon cards, but usually if people are going to pass me Sling Gang Lieutenant and Munitions Expert, I'm happy to just go for it. Alright, we're looking at deck lists from the Modern Challenge a moment ago. I was kind of interested in this new take on Hollow One. Basically just Hollow One with three Lightning Skelementals and Seasoned Pyromancer. A couple Unearths. Looks totally reasonable. This can't be real, right? Two mono blue Tron decks in the top 8 of the Modern Challenge. Did this deck gain anything to make it good all of a sudden? So not even playing the Great Creator. Got some Jund in ninth place. Factor Fiction it gained. This plays like one Factor Fiction though. It can't even be that much better than like Gifts Ungiven or whatever they used to play. So I may actually just matron for another matron here, because if I miss my land drop, then I won't have any play to make, and having Feaster of Fools and Munitions Expert, the incidental bodies certainly do seem to matter. So I guess I'll just go for the long run value. Gonna get Crypt Rats or something like that. Well, I could just make a giant Feaster of Fools again and sort of hope my opponent doesn't have Mob. Seven should be sufficiently large to dodge all the red removal and then just basically make them have mob. So for a red-black mirror, I want to really be prepared with all my most grindy technology. Might stop short of Mind Rake, but all the Raised Deads and the second Gargantua. I actually don't mind having one kind of grizzly bear card just to hold off the tokens. And Dragonheart's definitely better, but I think I just want the cheaper card, especially for this game when I'm on the draw. Alright, shoes on the other foot this time. Okay, whenever it or another goblin dies, you deal 1 damage to any target. That is not great news for me. Well, I could just go all in on Feaster of Fools again this game and hope it works out. My opponent could have Goat Nap or Mob this time. I can also Matron for a Munitions Expert to try to kill off Pashalic Mons, but can definitely expect some number of unearths and or grave shifters and or return from extinctions from my opponent. Sure. Well, I feel like I'm just gonna make a giant Feaster of Fools. 11-11 or something. At least 9-9. All right. I have an 11-11. Do you have the answer? Goat nap would be pretty bad for me. Yep. Not great. Yeah, I guess it would have been better to kill the Dragonheart instead of the Ninja. My thought process was my Feaster of Fools is going to be the only untapped creature. And if my opponent attacks with the 6/3 Ninja, I basically have to block, and then my creature will die to Magmatic Sinkhole. So maybe I should have killed the. I mean, basically, if I leave the 6/3 Ninja, I'm just going to die to combat damage to the Goat Nap. So I don't know. That was a tricky turn, a lot to think about. I basically just decided that I was gonna play to beat, anything besides Goat Nap or Mob. All right, multiple goat naps, so I'll be careful with the Feaster of Fools next time around. Wonder if I'm even supposed to board it out after seeing those. Yep. Not loving my position here. Endling. Yeah, this is gonna be bad. I think I may need to be aggressive in order to win this game. Froggler says attack first because you can bring it back both if he trades with the Venomous Changeling. The problem is he's just not going to trade with the Venomous Changeling and then my creature will be tapped. So, notably not casting the Venomous Changeling that I know about. So, representing what? Mob? Endling pumps? File. feel like my main way to win this game is to get off a really nice mind rake where I strip away some essential pieces that my opponent's counting on. Sure. That was a pretty good turn. At least we have a plan. Yep. Reprint Tybalt, thank you for the sub. So the reason I did the Defile on my main phase is so that I could sacrifice whatever creature my opponent targeted with the triggered ability. And then also my opponent might be worried about activating this because then the shields are down on the endling. But it was a tough call. So I think this is my only block right now. Be a good time for a nice draw step, like a Goblin War Party. Well, it still feels like my opponent has to have something to beat me. And even if they can answer the Dragonheart, I'm still drawing to Sling Gang Commander or, you know, a way to rebuy the Goblin Matron, something like that. So Sling Gang, two Return from Extinctions, Unearth. So, if I take the damage, 4, 5, plus 4 is 9. So I'm not dead to Fists of Flame, not dead to Umezawa's Charm. Oh, actually I would be because of the Endling Pump. So Fists of Flame, Umezawa's Charm, Urza's Rage. But the tricky part is, if I chump with one creature, I don't have guaranteed lethal next turn. Can't really block with both creatures because then I'm just not even beating the board. So it seems like the only reasonable play I can make is like Goblin Matron in front of Goblin Token. And then I can lose to something like a Pyrophobia, just killing my creature and then being short of lethal. But at least I would get another draw step if my opponent has like Umezawa's Charm or single target removal spell. So that seems like my best bet is to block one creature, and then on the board I'd be taking, you know, effectively 10 damage. I'm not dead to any single card that I can think of, but my opponent could survive. Oh, the Ninja of the New Moon. Let's think about that. That would be, in order to not die to the Ninja of the New Moon, I would have to double block the Endbringer, which is just seems like a play that I can't really make, right? I can't make a play that's so safe that I'm not beating the board, so I think this is the only reasonable thing. Oh, and my opponent only has 3 mana up anyway, yeah. So there's no Ninja of the New Moon. Hey, Jarvis. Thanks for coming, man. How are you? I might be able to beat Urza's Rage. Like, if my opponent has Urza's Rage and I block like this, I think their play is just Urza's Rage the Goblin token right now, and then any creature wins the game for me. Well, the Dragonheart's already a 4/4, and on my turn, I'll just attack with both creatures. My opponent will have to make the first move, and if they target the Dragonheart, I make it 4/4 in response. Ooh, that was a good match, a good final boss. But I do end up with the trophy, so pretty sweet with the red-black deck there. Okay, sometimes the draft queues take a long time, so I'm going to join now. We'll see. 6 of 8, so it might not take that long this time. No, I lost the game in that. That was a match 3, game 3 there, so that was for all the marbles, as we say in the business. Oh yeah, there you are. Beers SC, 39 trophies. It's one or two more than I have. I think I'm going to play some M20 Limited tomorrow on stream. Today I'm going to play Modern Horizons. Brick even asks about White Weenie from the old format. I concluded that Azorius was the best. I think the Red Splash was like sort of just the hot thing for a week or two, but I think it was not the best version. I think Azorius was. Got there with the Goblin deck, indeed. So Modern Horizons Draft League on Magic Online is Swiss, which means you get to play 3 rounds no matter what. And you get prizes if you go 2-1 or 3-0. And of course, each match is best 2 out of 3, so you can play up to 9 games. Ooh, Hogak. To be honest with you, this is a card I have not had in Modern Horizons Draft yet. I think it's good. Takes a little bit of work to use it well, but I think I'm pretty happy to first pick that. Otherwise, we could be looking at Secluded Step, Answered Prayers, Manowar, Trumpeting Herd. So I'll just take Hogak. Got to get some reps with it anyway. Um, like to have one of the premium uncommons or rares before I take the Goblin Matron. Scale up is like kind of cute in some decks. Probably more inclined to just take a basic green creature like a Rhyme Tender from this pack. Yeah, I think I'm going to take a green card, and I think my preferred green card here is Rhyme Tender. If I had first picked a snow card, I might take the snow-covered forest before the Rhyme Tender, but I'm just going to take the creature here. All right, well, it broke my heart. I shed a tear to pass this card in the last draft. I will not be passing it again. I'm going to take Reap the Past and go red-green or Jund or something like that. Here I'm looking at Astrolabe, Ambusher, Snow Swamp. I guess I'll take Snow Swamp. I mean, I don't really like to take the Astrolabe before I have like four or five Snowlands. And the Ambusher seems like it's going to be replaceable if I'm going for a late game value deck. No, Carrion Feeder is not... I would not describe Carrion Feeder as super strong. I think it's good in certain archetypes, but... Now, actually, aside from Hogak being, you know, hybrid, I don't have any black cards yet, so I would normally be interested in either Force of Despair or Crypt Rats. But I think I'm going to go for Frostwalla from this pack since I, you know, plan A is kind of still to be red-green. So, Buktala says the lands come later than the Astrolabes. That's true, but you got to think about, like, there's a... The disaster case is to spend your early picks on the Astrolabe and then not get the Snowlands, and then you can't use anything. But if you take the Snowlands, then at least you have the Snowlands, you know? Like... You want to avoid the fail case, basically. And Snow Forest looks like a slam dunk at this point. No, 8 snowlands per pack, not 15. Well, at least we haven't seen a Snowland missing from any packs yet, so it doesn't seem like I'm fighting for it, at least not yet. So we have some strong white and black cards wheeling from this pack. Even if I go black-green, these are not exactly the black cards that I'm super intrigued by. So a little bit of a dud pack here. I guess I'll just take Secluded Step, you know, because it's the best card. Oh yeah, Dead of Winter would hit the spot. It's one of my favorite cards in Modern Horizons. If I'm going to play with Hogak, then I'm definitely looking for stuff like Winding Way and Ransack the Lab. Yeah, Jarvis has been brewing Dead of Winter Legacy decks, which I'm very intrigued by. I always used to want to use the card Withering Wisps. Anybody familiar with that one? I tried that in some of my old Pox decks back in the day. Well, that's a late Goblin Matron, but I'm not really in a position to use it, so I'll just take a green creature. So Withering Wisps is basically the same card as Pestilence, except it only costs 3 mana instead of 4, and you can only use Snow Swamps to activate it. Ooh, perfect. Okay, well, I guess I'll be playing black. Just open. They set my packs with two insane black bomb rares. Well, are you guys sure? I'm kind of looking at the Snow Mountain. Do you think maybe I should take the Snow Mountain from this pack just to make sure I have it, make sure I can cast that Astrolabe? This is good. This is good. This is good. This is good. Guess I'll go with Pyrophobia. Love this card. Ooh, a Snowland missing. So it looks like I passed an Astrolabe, like middle of pack one, and somebody probably downstream of me decided they wanted to draft Snow. It's okay. I mean, I think it's going to work out worse for them than for me. And in the meantime, Saddle Rhyme Stag is looking good. Sling Gang is just good enough, I think, even in a non-goblin deck. Nice way to generate some bodies alongside Yawgmoth. Mob would be good, of course, as well. I think I lean towards Sling Gang over Yawgmoth. Also, Convoke bodies for the Hogak. Kind of interesting, like a Jund Goblin Matron deck is actually possible here, but I think I'm going to take a Snow Mountain. Wow, Smiting Helix? Well, this is great in a black deck that has Arkham's Astrolabe. Actually, shocking that this would go pick 7, since it's good just in any black deck. I still need to get Winding Way and Ransack the Lab. Regrowth, Ransack. I think I need Ransack. I don't really know what my mana is going to look like just yet. I mean, I guess I'm going to be base black green. Or just three colors equal with an Astrolabe and hope it works out. The card quality is just really high, though. Like, three of the most powerful rares in the set, several of the most powerful uncommons. This is probably a deck where I can feel comfortable playing 18, maybe even 19 lands, so I don't have to stretch too far for playables. Frost Walla over Snow Mountain, I think is right. So far, the only thing that makes me want to have a ton of snow lands is the Astrolabe. But I'm doing pretty well with five on-color snow lands at this point. Both these cards seem pretty nice for me. Either Spider. Guess I'll go with the Webweaver. Goes well if I pick up Return from Extinction too. Nice, another Snow Mountain. Arkham's Astrolabe does produce snow mana, yes. Alright, so Morphon the Boundless naming Avatar. That's the plan, right? This card is good in theory, although I haven't really found the Winding Ways and Ransack the Labs that I need to make it great. Probably just taking Sinkhole, I guess. Maybe I can wheel the Ruination Rider. Reasonable with Smiting Helix. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 considerations here. Spider's good with both Hogak and Yawgmoth, and it's just like a nice curve filler defensive creature. I guess I'll go with Spider. Maybe be fortunate enough to wheel the Snow Swamp. One, 2, 3, 4, 5 interesting cards here. I think Pyrophobia is a little too good to pass. So another spider, another snow forest. Could like another snow forest. Currently at 19 playables laid out here. Maybe if I cut the Spore Frog and the Bellowing Elk, it's like 17, 16 cards that I'm pretty happy with. I guess that's not a lot. Maybe I should be taking up a playable. I really would love to have one more Snowland to feel comfortable casting the Astrolabe. But I guess I'll take Spider. Cat, thank you for the host. Welcome to everybody who's coming from Cat's stream. Just rounding out a pretty sweet Jund draft deck in Modern Horizons here. Would love another Astrolabe to fix my mana, but Firebolt's probably too good. There's a Winding Way. This is the card I've been waiting for. Ooh, Ransack or Snow Forest. I'm going to take Snow Forest. Because Winding Way is like amazing because it sees four cards and green is going to be my base color. But I may only have like, I don't know, five swamps in my deck or something. Which makes Ransack a little more sketchy. Didn't wind up with that many snow payoffs though. So maybe I should just take the Ransack. Yeah, I mean, I guess the only thing the Snow Forest is doing for me is make me feel a little more comfortable casting my one Astrolabe. So I should just take the Ransack instead. Now the Ruination Rider is getting a little more interesting with double Ransack Winding Way. Might actually deal some damage when it dies. Okay, so no shortage of snow lands. I guess my deck's probably going to look like that, maybe. Bellowing Elk's actually pretty bad, I think, in this deck. Just because I'm a little more defensive. Maybe not. I mean, maybe just between Rhymestag, Frostwalla, and Elk, I can beat down pretty well. So I want at least six more forests. Maybe I can get away with four mountains, because aside from the Ruination Rider, most of my stuff doesn't need to be cast until later. Sure, one more swamp to cast the Ransacks and the Yawgmoth early on. My mana is not great, but I still like this deck. Power level's high, good late game. Nice aggressive start from my opponent. Okay, so I think my plan is Snow Swamp, Winding Way for creature, and then Ruination Rider. I hit Yawgmoth. And I binned one Snow Covered Forest. So, I'll probably just try to block the Alpine Guide and trade off. That's a card. Especially with the Astrolabe. This is quite the combo. Still, I think I'll try to stabilize with creatures to whatever degree I can. This is a judgment call, but I think I'm just going to clear the board. It's actually really good. So I guess I go Ransack and Sling Gang. Now we're just waiting to draw Reap the Past. All right, the plan remains. Sit around and wait till I draw Reap the Past. I'm going to delve away, Ransack, Winding Way, Ransack, and then a couple of lands. I should tap my goblin, I guess, there. Grave Shifter is a nice one. Firebolt looking good. Guess I just kill off these two. Oh, that's not what I meant to do. Shoot. I meant to kill the Graveshifter, but I just spaced there. Should be fine. If my opponent doesn't have an answer to Hogak, they're just gonna be piecemealed to death with the Sling Gang and the Smiting Helix. Yeah, some nice highlights in this deck. Reap the Past, too. So this trifecta of really good rares. Generally high card quality, mediocre mana, probably missing like a Grave Shifter to make this deck perfect, but it's good. I'll take it. Right, just missing a red in six, exactly. Good draw. I suppose I'll be waiting on the Hogak for a little while. So if I attack again, opponent blocks the Rhyme Stag, take 3 down to 6, then I reap for 2, replay Rhyme Stag, and I have Smiting Helix in my hand. Is that good? Probably not. I probably just want to do nothing. Just be a little patient. Still doesn't do much. Looks like my opponent probably has Smiting Helix as well. I could multi-block like that. It's not really that much risk because of I can just rebuy them all effectively for free. Yeah, that worked out fine. I could take quite a big hit this turn. Okay, so with 8 mana, I definitely want to play out the Spore Frog. Maybe I don't need to use the definitelys so fast and loose. Yeah, I'll just play 8 mana worth of creatures. Bellowing Elk trades with a Gargantua, so that's a decent card to have. Spore Frog also does seem decent. Anything I don't want? Maybe that's the weakest. The saddest mulligan ever. Five lands with all my colors and two of my best cards, and I have to mulligan. I'm actually gonna bottom the sinkhole, I think. Well, am I? Because that's less of a. That's more of a card I want to find later, less of a development type card. Okay, I like the way this is developing. So, we're gonna make some black mana. Kill this slug before it gets out of hand, and Pyrophobia is also perfect because I can just get it back later with Reap the Past. That. I'm going to try to hold on until I can reap for 4 or 5. I think with how grindy my opponent's deck is, I need to get as much value out of this card as I can. And doing it for 3, it's just really easy for my opponent to outfight that, especially if I get a little unlucky with which cards come back. So now at the spot where we're doing it for 4, it becomes kind of a fair question. Like, say I get unlucky and I return everything other than the Sling Gang. It's still probably good enough to find a way to win. I'll go for it. Okay, so everything besides Pyrophobia. That's pretty good pickup. I think I want to ransack before anything else. And I found Hogak, which is just beautiful. So I'm going to take Winding Way. I'm going to Winding Way naming creature. I binned a Helix and I picked up a Frostwalla. Then I'll play Spider. Okay, so my opponent's going to disallow me from making Hogak this turn. But the Lava Dart's gone now, which means that Sling Gang Commander can become a more relevant card. With 8 mana, I think I want to do Sling Gang and Frostwalla. So I'll do Frostwalla first. And we'll actually do the full Convoke. Yeah, actually, quick correction, Rain. I'm going to be traveling for the Mythic Championship starting on Thursday, so no stream on Thursday. It's just going to be extended streams today and tomorrow, and today will be Modern Horizons draft. Tomorrow is going to be probably M20 Limited. Maybe I'll dip my toes into some Standard, but something on MTG Arena. Channel Fireball is a great place to go based on the sheer amount of buying they do. They have fair and reliable prices on cards. They have store credit bonus with trade-ins. You can count on ChannelFireball.com for all your magic needs. Hello, Pork Belly. Thanks for coming to the stream today. I would say I'm not done with Modern testing, but I don't know that I'm going to have another opportunity to stream Modern before the Mythic Championship. Generally, like, the closer to the tournament it gets, the more I like to play things close to the vest, you know, so people aren't, people don't know exactly what I'm going to bring. Mythic Championship is in Barcelona. That's funny to see you asking that, Beers, because I would have assumed with the 40 trophies on Magic Online that you were competing in the Mythic Championship, but I guess you're just a lover of booster draft, huh? Well, I got another red-black matchup. Little awkward. I would love to just Firebolt the Sliver, but I think it's better for me to play one of my 4-mana creatures this turn. Okay, so I can't cast Yawgmoth yet. I guess take 6 and then I'll firebolt the sliver. Tempting to just deal 8 there, and then I have my opponent at 10, 3 points from the sling gang, 4 points from the firebolt. Pretty tough judgment call. So if I just firebolt the Dragonheart and my opponent lets it go, then I attack. Opponent goes block here, block here. I trade, take 3. Not great. So then the question becomes, should I start my turn with Ransack the Lab, or should I just Firebolt the Dragonheart? Alternatively, I could attack with Frostwalla, and if my opponent blocks with Slug, then I can just Firebolt the Slug post-combat. Maybe that's good, and because I also think that trading Frostwalla against Cyclops is probably favorable for me. And if my opponent goes double block with Slug and Dragonheart, that's probably the worst outcome, actually. All right, I'm going to start with Ransack. Quick check if I have any double green cards. I do not. I think I just take the Snow Swamp. It's so strong to cast Yawgmoth on this board. Sure. Sure. It's pretty scary. I guess I'm going to sack the lieutenant just because I do want to find more action. A little bit awkward targeting the slug because it can just get the counters back. Wow. Hogak with no creatures left. Alright. So I begin my turn with tap mountain, cast Astrolabe. Then I think I just play this. And I think I'm in a fine position to trade 3 damage for 2. It's kind of borderline, but since I have the Smiting Helix in my graveyard, I feel okay doing it. We're drawing to reap the past, or pretty much any creature, I guess. Sure. Yep. There we go. All right, so I have 11 mana, and I have 9 cards in my graveyard, so I could get them all. And yeah, I mean, it seems like probably would be too fancy to get less than all of them. So let's see, if I get 8 and I'll pick up the forest. Yeah, I don't know. There might be some kind of like galaxy brain permutation where it's right to not do it for everything, but I'm just going to do it for everything. It's basically exactly the same matchup I just played a second ago. Solid hand. Just seems like a fine play to make. I mean, I don't have to do that because the spider can probably hold off the carrion feeder starting next turn, but might as well use my mana. So I could sinkhole and hit for four again. I actually have drawn pretty much all of the non-snow lands in my deck, funny enough. So the Frostball is not that impressive. So getting my opponent down to nine and then effectively eight and then effectively five, it seems good. I think I should just keep the pressure on. I think it's fine to just swing here. Like, if I get my opponent low enough that A, they have to think twice about unearthing the Gargantua, and B, that drawing into either Astrolabe or Reap the Past can be lethal, then I just really like my position. Yes, Frostwall down. Well, I actually like my attack here because My opponent doesn't want to go to three, so they might wind up chumping a spider token. I mean, the obvious play is like triple block one spider, but then three is not a great number to be at. I'm probably dead to another war party, but that would have been more or less the case if I didn't attack also. Okay, no second war party. That's good news. We're drawing two Astrolabe or Reap the Past for the instant win. Am I dead? I am dead. Close game. I needed, I think, one more strong draw step towards the end there, which I didn't get, but I'm pretty happy with the way I chose to play it. I mean, I gave myself a chance to win despite drawing a pretty unhealthy mix of lands and spells. Beers, do you think it was right for my opponent to go down to three against the three spider tokens? Like, my main thought was I probably hold back Quakefoot Cyclops on that turn so that I can stay above, well, above being dead to the Smiting Helix in the graveyard. Beautiful hand, beautiful hand. If I find a spider, I could potentially have turn three Hogak. Oh no, the combo. Ransack and Bin of Gargantua. Okay. That seems good, honestly. Just playing Yawgmoth. I guess I'll attack with Frostwalla before anything else. Okay. So now Winding Way is going to name creature. Bend four cards, including Firebolt. So now I guess I just delve everything besides the Firebolt and play Hogak. Mob on Yawgmoth. All right, so I kind of want to kill off the Spinehorn Minotaur. So let's say I float a black mana, untap the swamp, target here. And the lands might actually just be better off in the graveyard than in play due to Hogak. So, it's very tricky. I'm deciding if I want to proliferate at all. I could proliferate twice, but then I would be. Left with. Yeah, if I proliferate twice and pump Frostwalla, I'll have no black mana or red mana left over for Pyrophobia. All right, I guess I'm just gonna pump my Frostwalla and let the Yawgmoth go. Yes, that's fine. Then post combat, finish that off. Amazing draw, of course. So I think I point the Pyrophobia at the Minotaur, and then I attack, and it'll probably be like block, block. Alright, a couple narrow wins against red-black decks. Awkward hand. That one's going to be thrown back. I try not to engage in this "what's your record" type of conversation. Should I bottom? Maybe just the ransack and try to curve out. So opponent chose land, found a forest and a plains. Redden asks, when is it reasonable to start picking snow-covered lands? Well, snow-covered forest is significantly better than the other snowlands, but I still wouldn't really pick them until I had a nice payoff. So yeah, I mean, I guess you could second pick snow-covered forest after a green snow card, but for the most part, the non-forest snowlands should not be very high picks early on, and yeah, I don't know. Snow-covered forest, you can start taking it once you have a reason. Okay, I'll be killing that. Thank you very much. Well, this game should be pretty sweet if and when I find red mana. Found my mountain. And I'm just going to trade off Frostwalla because I am looking to fill my graveyard for Reap the Past. So even though if my opponent double blocks, it's like a slightly unfavorable trade. A slightly unfavorable trade becomes palatable when you've reaped the past in your hand. Probably wait one more turn. I can chump block the Anurid with the Twin Silk Spider, which gives me a little extra value. That's scary. Well, probably losing this game. I might need to draw Hogak or something. I don't even know. Something good. All right. And I did find Hogak. Hey, Bobby Schultz, thanks for the sub. I think I'm going to take this damage. Kind of unintuitive, but I would rather attack with the Hogak, and then if my opponent blocks and has Elvish Fury or something, I could at least finish off the blocking creature with burn spells. Something fishy is going on. Might be Elvish Fury. So now we go reap for 4, which will have me picking up the firebolt, and I can finish off the aneurid with the firebolt. It was Elvish Fury. I guessed right. Well, I guess I partially guessed right. There was Elvish Fury plus more. I guess for the same reason as before, I'm going to take the damage. What do we think it is now? Wing shards or something? I mean, could be another Elvish Fury, could be wing shards. I think I'm gonna try not to overthink myself, and I'm just gonna attack with Hogak only. Maybe my opponent doesn't know it has trample, which is unfortunate. Eight mana, so we go. Ooh, I love this hand. Yawgmoth against the white-green deck should be nice. All right. probably, man, this is kind of a tricky conceptual question. Like, do I want to play Rhyme Tender to develop my mana quickly? Do I want to play Rhyme Stag and try to race? Do I want to play Rhyme Stag and try to trade off? I guess I'm going to play Rhyme Tender because Yawgmoth is just so strong. Particularly, like, even if my turn three is play Yawgmoth and trade Rhyme Tender for Ambusher, that's good enough. Chooses creature for Winding Way, but big brick there. If only this was a human. Okay, my opponent decides to pack it in, so that's two trophies in a row, feeling good.